Go ahead, Eddie. Light up and take a poke, and he'll turn you on. Hey, Eddie, this isn't the first time you've tried pot. Okay, we'll give you exactly 30 minutes to make up your mind, to decide for yourself whether pot is worth it.
La, 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 pot, pot, give us some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. High, high, I want to get high. Never give it up if you give it a try. Pot, pot, give us some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. La, 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 la.
Actually, as much as I'd like to deny the fact that pot was the beginning of my uses of drugs, it's there as a fact. It was the beginning of my using of drugs.
La, 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 pot, pot, give me some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. Tough, tough, the world is so tough. When it gets harder, you can try harder stuff.
You know, I didn't care if I lived or died, so I didn't care if I used, you know, shot dope or if I took an OD or what.
I had too much. I was building a big thing up over a week, and I got sick, and I tried to commit suicide.
La, 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 pot, pot, give me some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. Hip, hip, you wanna be hip. You know at all if you don't take a trip. La, la.
Remember, Eddie, when you were busted, caught with marijuana in your possession? What's the use? For every reason against pot, you can give two for. But how can you communicate with the establishment? Okay, Eddie, we'll let you talk to your own kind. Cats who are hip, who know the truth about pot, not from books, but from experience. Gary McCormick, U.S. Air Force, 1951 to 1955.
John Burrell, U.S. Army, World War II.
Fred Phillips, U.S. Navy, World War II.
Relax, Eddie. You're among buddies now. We've all smoked pot for more years than you've lived. Eddie, why do you want a trip on marijuana? Help him out, John.
What's wrong with pot? We all live in a pressure cooker world. The lid's ready to blow any minute. Just to get along today, everybody's got to have his own thing. Society says it's okay for mom to have her aspirins, sleeping pills, tranquilizers, yeah, even the pill. It's okay for Dad to come home and guzzle his martinis after piling up the do-re-mi, trying to keep up with the neighbors. Bread's the name of the game. Dad says be honest while he cheats in his business, on his income tax, anything to get ahead. Cheat, cheat, cheat.
Yeah, you're damn right.
Man, they're all screwed up. They talk the talk, but they don't walk the walk. Who wants to live like them? No wonder the kids today are rebelling, developing their own lifestyle.
In the service, it's even worse. Do this, do that, wake up, lights out, tension, at ease. Man, just to keep them blowing your stack, you've got to have your own bag. Anyway, what's wrong with pot? It's not habit-forming. You can't get cancer smoking it. So you get yourself a high, so what? Is it any worse than booze?
Pot, pot, give me some pot. Get what you are, you can be what you're not.
Forget whether pot is good or bad for you, Eddie. Why do you need to cop out? Okay, Eddie, listen to what some ex-dope addicts say about pot.
I started smoking pot in high school because I was bored and looking for a new kick.
Kids get started on pot because they're very curious and they want to start a new thing.
When I was in high school, all my friends used pot. I did it because I didn't want to look chicken.
I started smoking pot when I was about 15 in high school. I seen a crowd there that was very popular and had a lot of fun and seemed to be into something. And I wanted to be a part of it.
In Korea, I was the only black man in our outfit. And talk about pressure and being alone and scared. But in smoking pot, it helped me make it.
What kind of help? How did it affect you?
How does pot affect you, Eddie?
You sure see life like it really is, right, Eddie?
At all?
Hell, man, pot's been around thousands of years. Still nobody knows much about it.
Well, let's find out a few things.
Pot, pot, give us some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. La, 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 la.
Other countries have had lots of experience with pot. We're beginning to do some experiments ourselves. Medics have finally come up with the stuff in pot that gives you the kick. It's a $5 word called tetrahydrocannabinol. Hell, man, I can't even say it. We know pot affects everyone differently. Eddie, you're going to take the equivalent of a couple of sticks, U.S. type. Go ahead, take it. Go on, drink it. Imagine you've been dragging on a reefer, Eddie. Now the smoke's in your lungs. Now it's in your bloodstream, on the way to your brain and nervous system. You're way up on weed, Eddie. How do you feel?
Man, I'm floating. I'm coming apart. These guys can't touch me. I'm living really. I'm floating over the whole damn universe.
You're back in Vietnam, Eddie. You hear those mortar shells?
Beautiful. Man, they're like church bells.
Scared, Eddie?
Nah, they can't hurt me. Nothing can hurt me.
How far away are they, Eddie?
Miles, tens, hundreds of miles.
How long between shells, Eddie?
Minutes, hours, who cares?
How about your reflexes, Eddie?
Man, I've got supernatural powers. Just try me.
What about everyday things? Like driving a car.
Man, just give me the wheel. Give me the wheel, baby.
Pot, pot, give us some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not. La, la.
San Ysidro, California, at the Mexican border. In May of last year, Sergeant T.J. Crippen returned from one of his regular monthly visits to Tijuana. Hidden under the hood of his car was a lid of marijuana to feed his daily habit of smoking a stick before reporting for duty. May 25th.
That morning I felt really stoned.
Look out!
Positioning my truck to refuel a KC-135, I barely missed the engine. Man, was I scared. Pot was beginning to affect my reactions.
That day, Sergeant Crippen decided to turn himself in. September of the same year, Republic of Vietnam. Three members of a supply company assigned to the motor pool had shared a stick, Vietnamese type, packing a far stronger wallop than U.S. marijuana. Tripping on pot, they decided to go on the town. They never got past the gate. But what if they had?
This
I never get behind a wheel. You lose all sense of reality.
Time, distance, even your memory gets all out of whack.
Pot brings out the worst in you. The queer instincts, the killer instincts. Because it happened to me while I was there in Korea. The killing part came out in me. I didn't like the idea of killing, but I had to, and I just became good at it.
June of last year. Special Forces Camp, Republic Vietnam. James Williams, member of a squad about to assume night defensive positions, smoked for the first time a hand-rolled Vietnamese reefer, given him by Joseph Grady. At 2000, Williams went on bunker guard duty. This was his testimony.
I felt I was about to die. Bubbles were going through my whole body. Something told me to go get Grady. I just had to get him. Grady! Come out here, so help me! Williams! Come back here! Let me alone. I gotta do it.
It's your last chance, William.
That night, Grady and two other men were killed. Williams seriously wounded.
So what? You read about it every day. Some coon going off his rocker. So what are they doing? They blame it on pot.
Anyone can go psycho if he takes enough tetrahydrocannabinol in his system, Eddie.
Man, oh man, you must think I'm stupid or something. You take 5 spoons of salt, 180 proof whiskey, and it'll knock you on your can too. Anyone who's hip knows when to quit on pot, how much it take to get as high.
What are your highs like, Eddie?
Do you always get a good trip?
I first smoked pot in World War II. It did me no good. It was like the walls of a room closing in on me.
Bangkok, April of this past year. 3 U.S. airmen being transferred from Taiwan to an Air Force base in Thailand stopped off here overnight. In Southeast Asia, marijuana can be bought in bars, restaurants, dance halls. The airmen made their purchase on the street. 6 joints at 16 cents U.S. money per joint. They picked a small side street hotel for their pot party.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Wow. Beautiful. Wow. Beautiful. Wow. Beautiful. Wow. Wow.
Everybody loves this song. Everybody loves this song.
Wow.
Everybody loves this song.
Yeah.
Everybody loves this song.
Wow.
Everybody loves this song.
Wow.
Everybody
prevent prevent detection of the smell of pot, the door had been sealed. The airman did not know there was a defective gas heater in that room. Next morning, Sergeant Henderson was found dead, asphyxiated. Sergeant Miles had choked on his own vomit. Only Sergeant Bryan would survive to tell what had happened.
So some guys got gassed.
They were out for kicks, Eddie. They come to depend on pot.
Oh, man, knock it off. They should be telling me you can get hooked on pot.
You're right, Eddie. Your body doesn't get to need pot like heroin or other hard stuff, but you can get hooked in a different way.
Starting last winter, I began using marijuana every day. I kept my supply in a field off base. I smoked alone or on my way to work. I'd come to look forward to every morning. I suppose it was all in my mind, but anyway, it became a habit. I couldn't, and I didn't want to break.
It's called psychological dependence.
Yeah, well, this cat can take it or leave it.
You're still an amateur, Eddie.
Don't con me. Isn't it time for the old numbers game? You know, how many guys went from pot to acid to meth to horse? Save your breath, because I know better.
Listen, stupid. Gary's got more tracks on his arm than you got freckles on your butt.
That's right, punk. It is the numbers game. That's the way it adds up. From pot to meth to horse. Take a look at this, buddy.
Beautiful, man, but dig this. In all the U.S., there are maybe 60 to 70,000 known heroin addicts, while millions of kids in high school and college have smoked pot.
Two brothers stationed in Korea, there they started smoking pot. They started using heroin in Korea also. About 2 years ago, one of my brothers died from an overdose of heroin.
In the last year or so, I've worked with many and many of addicts, and they all started on pot.
When you're looking for a better high, next grooviest thing is horse.
One of the worst things about pot, it leads you to a pusher.
Pot, pot, give me some pot. Forget what you are, you can be what you're not.
Oh. New York City, August of last year. Two detectives from the Bureau of Narcotics had under surveillance a high school student, George Keeling, known to be a marijuana pusher. To determine his source, his arrest had been delayed. San Francisco. A week later, a package arrived from Vietnam sent by one Corporal Thomas Keeling, addressed to his brother, George Keeling. Opened by a mail examiner in the Customs Mail Bureau, the package contained merely a souvenir pillow. Concealed within it, however, was 1 pound of marijuana, Vietnam grass. After the postal inspector was notified, the package was resealed and sent by special mail pouch to the General Post Office in New York City. Upon its receipt, the Customs Agency Service was advised. The U.S. attorney was promptly informed. In turn, he notified the New York City police, as well as the military authorities. On August 22nd, the police, accompanied by a postal inspector, entered the Keeling flat. The package with its contents was seized, and 17-year-old George Keeling was arrested. The scene shifts to Saigon. There, Thomas Keeling, who had been apprehended and punished before for use of marijuana, now faced a general court-martial. The penalties for possession, use, transfer, or sale of marijuana in the military service are severe, ranging from a term of imprisonment with forfeiture of pay to dishonorable discharge and up to 5 years of hard labor. Thomas Keeling received the maximum.
Dishonorable discharge means losing your GI rights, Eddie, your home loan, thousands of dollars in training and education benefits, as well as your self-respect.
Whether you like it or not, it's illegal, Eddie. get it through your thick skull. It's against the law.
If you're a civilian and get busted, you get yourself in a hell of a lot of trouble.
You can go psycho. You can hurt yourself or someone else.
January, Mekong Delta, Vietnam. Howard Ferguson was diagnosed to be in a psychotic state. A supply of marijuana had been found in his locker. The day before, he'd been acting strangely, picking fights with his shipmates. This was the period of the Tet Offensive. Howard Ferguson wasn't much use in defense of his buddies that day.
Back in Vietnam, Eddie. You ever have a buddy? What happened to him? Eddie, why do you need pot?
What's your hang-up, Eddie?
Come on, tough guy, and level with us.
What kind of guys fool around with pot? Speak up, Eddie!
Fred, remember? You were a pothead. Busted three times.
You thought the law couldn't touch you.
First you got 3 months. Next six. Last time a year.
What were you, Fred?
Tell him, Fred. What were you?
Stupid, I guess.
Louder.
Stupid.
Louder.
Stupid! Stupid!
Who do you live with, Fred?
My mother.
Who takes care of you, Fred?
My mother.
Who makes your bed? Cleans your clothes? Pays your bills?
My mother.
Take a good look at yourself, Fred. What do you see?
What are you, Fred? What kind of guy are you?
A baby. A baby! A baby!
Grow up, Fred. Take on the responsibilities of a man.
If you want to change the world, get with it. But quit running away from your problems.
Eddie, remember your buddy? He smoked pot.
Tommy, try some.
Nah, I get nothing from it.
You know I gotta take care of you.
Cut it out, Ed.
Makes you feel real groovy. Like gun home.
VC, let's get him.
Eddie, those woods are full of VC.
Come on, don't be chicken. The woods are a mile away.
You're crazy, Eddie. They're right on us.
Go on, take a powder. I'll go along.
Eddie, come back.
Inside, I'm pretty weak. The tough guy was just a cover-up. It's been that way all my life.
wife, Eddie?
It's a beginning.
The jury's still out on just how bad pot is for you. But you be your own judge and jury. 30 minutes ago, we said we'd let you make up your own mind. Time's up, Eddie. Eddie's not alone. Some of you watching this film may one day sit in that chair. Is pot worth it? Ask yourself. Is pot really worth it? Think about it. Truth that I feel.